multiple people down. We need a lot of ambulances.
Initial 911 dispatches from the scene only hint at the horror unfolding inside.
We have one victim who was shot and bleeding at the entrance.
College Country Night at Borderline Bar in Thousand Oaks, California, outside of Los Angeles, had drawn a crowd of more than 100 young patrons. Parents now just beginning to learn which of their children will never return.
Oh, son, I love you so much. Oh, Heavenly Father, just please.
The gunman, Ian David Long, was a 28-year-old war veteran who entered the bar just before 11:30 p.m. carrying a .45-caliber Glock and an extended magazine.
I saw him point to the back of the cash register, and he just kept firing.
He shot the front doorman, bouncer.
Well, yeah, just a young man,
and then he shot the cashier.
First responders rushed to the scene as survivors scramble to escape.
So they, unfortunately, our young people or people at nightclubs have learned that this may happen, and they think about that.
Many broke through bar windows while others ran to hide in bathrooms and attics.
Friends got the bar stools and they started slamming against the window so we could get out.
Victims were carried out one by one and desperate life-saving efforts took place in the parking lot. Still, many remained inside.
We're still missing two people. We can't find them.
The gunman was found dead inside the bar's front office, an apparent suicide, according to police. We are now learning he was a former Marine and infantry machine gunner who served in Afghanistan. He was also known to police. Last April, law enforcement responded to a domestic disturbance at this Newberry Park home where he lived with his mother.
The mental health experts out there cleared him that day. The deputies went out to the call with the crisis team that felt he might be suffering from PTSD.
Richard Berg, who lives a block and a half away, tells us Long's mother feared for his future.
She might have been afraid of him herself. I don't know. She never said that, but she was living in hell.